dozens of quarantine patients have left this weekend, killing 10 more people. In the Middle East, Iran reporting dozens of new cases overnight. Bethlehem now under a coronavirus lockdown. Trains to fly to Tel Aviv, Israel, for the very latest today.
Martha, good afternoon. As the global number of coronavirus cases continues to rise, countries outside the United States are taking extreme measures to ensure the safety of their civilians. West Bank town hall of Bethlehem is completely locked down after 19 cases were confirmed there. The closure is affecting a group of 13 American tourists who are being told to self-quarantine in a nearby hotel. That hotel is reportedly being guarded by security forces. There's extensive coordination between Israelis and Palestinians on this issue, as new checkpoints are being implemented and mosques are being closed. Much further east in the country, Iran, the death toll from coronavirus is nearing 200. Yesterday alone, 49 deaths were reported. Israeli authorities have found more than 6,000 positive cases. And in China, millions do remain under quarantine. Yesterday, as you mentioned, a Chinese hotel that was housing people under observation collapsed. The incident killed at least 10 people that were for other survivors. Now here in Israel, there are 28 confirmed cases of coronavirus, as more than 100,000 residents do remain under self-quarantine. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu held a press conference tonight saying that list of countries where people have traveled from to Israel could expand, making more self-quarantine mandatory for Israel. Another important note here, there is a political battle going on in the days after a new election. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu versus his main opponent, Benny Gantz, both have some key points they would like to say to voters about who might be better suited when it comes to trying to form a government that could combat this virus.
Trey Gaines, thank you very much.
Although back here at home, the White House responded to news that someone who had visited that conference in Maryland last week has tested positive for coronavirus. President Trump and Vice President Pence, well, they were both there speaking at CPAC. But the White House tells us there is no reason to believe that either of them were ever in close proximity to that person. Kevin Cork is in West Palm Beach to the President of Maryland.
No problem. Everything's in place in that
officials, there is absolutely no consideration for this idea of not traveling and doing major large-scale events. And so that means events like CPAC will certainly continue.